Hello, I'm Gary Siskar with Liquid Force Kiteboarding. Brandon Scheid and myself are excited to introduce WOW version 4. The WOW is our surf-specific kite. Personally, I'm really excited about this kite as I feel it's the best one yet. It went undergone a complete redesign, a new shape, a new profile, which we'll get into later. But if you are traveling the world looking for the best surf, if you are slashing the pocket, hunting for the barrel, or if you're really into just lofting strapless airs, this WOW is gonna deliver the performance and confidence that you're looking for.
Hey everybody, it's Brandon Scheid from Liquid Force. And as Gary said, we just got done designing the WOW V4 and bringing it to market. We're super excited about where it sits in our range and who this kite is for. And I wanna explain how we were able to take this kite from what was the WOW V3 into the WOW V4 and how we achieved some of those design goals that were set out going forward for that. So one of the big design goals was to give the kite, engage the sweet spot, make it bigger, make the kite have a little bit more raw power. So we changed that first and foremost by adding a really boxy shape to the shape arc of the kite. Now you might not be able to see it quite from this whole avenue of the kite, but what we were able to achieve is the wingtip essentially stops here at this strut. So we have a very short and stout wingtip and a very wide and kind of flatter center of the canopy that gives the kite more of a box shape in its arc and allows us to have more raw power in the kite and increase the range of that sweet spot to allow you to have, you know, a kite that is forgiving and effortless in a variety of conditions. Now that boxy feel was also enhanced by the change in the profile of the kite. We were able to flatten out the kite here through the canopy and into the wingtips, which gave us a faster, more efficient profile, as well as increase the turning speed of the kite to give us a lot more response in the turning speed. And the combination of those two things actually moved the arcing point of the kite from the wingtip further into the middle of the kite, which means instead of your kite pivoting around the wingtip and really arcing through its turn, it's actually turning more on itself and becoming a lot more positionable in where you want that kite to go. So we increase the maneuverability of the kite as well as the forgiveness and the raw power in the profile and the wingtip. That's something we're stoked on. Now, in terms of turning speed, I said we made it faster. You know, that's something to say, but when we have a design implement that backs that up, we were able to reduce this sweep in this wingtip here and make the wingtip go drastically deep back into the frame of the canopy. So that gave us a longer wingtip, something that allowed us to get more turning response and gave us more rigidity in the shape of the kite. So we have a kite that's not only turns quicker and responds to that turns quicker, but it's a lot more rigid and easier to relaunch. Now, as you can see, that wingtip carries up into our leading edge. And for those of you that are familiar with the WOW, you'll know that it came with a narrow leading edge to really push that kite to the edge of the wind window and really make the kite fast and zippy. Moving from 3 to 4, that is the WOW versions, we've actually increased the diameter of the leading edge slightly to give us a little bit more rigidity and give people something that'll stand up when it gets pounded in the surf, or something you don't have to inflate super, super firm to go out on your session, but it's still gonna drive that kite forward, make this kite boost really well, and really help give you the most angle attack on the wave so that you can really put the kite where you want it. So that's kind of the basic shape and profile things. Obviously, as you change the profile of the kite, you gotta adjust the bridle. You can't just throw the same bridle on there. For us, it's important that we have a static bridle. That's something that's really reliable and isn't gonna break, and no moving parts or pulleys. And that gives you a really direct, responsive feel. You can see it's short and compact. It has a hard time even getting down here to the wingtip, so you don't have to worry about bridle wrap around the wingtip or anything like that. You're gonna notice it comes in different segments. We have a heavier segment and some flying line attachments. We use the flying line because we believe it's lighter, and as well, it reduces drag. So that makes the kite faster and move quicker through the wind window. As always, our kites are bomb proof. You know, we build them with the highest quality materials that we can get our hands on. And that's really important for us, not only to have a kite that you can ride and trust and rely, but a kite that in 3 years doesn't look like a bag of tissue paper or just kind of a beat up old thing. You know, we want those kites to be able to stay crispy and feel crispy through the life of the kite. So we use the highest quality materials. We're here with a Tasian triple ripstop and a Tasian Dacron. Those two materials are accepted in the industry as the strongest weight ratio material, as well as the best for rip abrasion resistance, as well as UV coating. So I don't know if you guys know that, but the sun is the most detrimental thing for your kite. So those coatings help reduce the amount of UV they're gonna take. And that really helps keep the kite going nice, strong, and long. We have our struts are connected directly to the canopy, so that gives us a nice rigidity in there. All our seams are triple stitched, glued. Anywhere you have a transition between a strong Dacron material and a canopy, you have a mar cloth in between, and that just helps keep that point really nice and crisp. Down here in the trailing edge, we do have a sprocket trailing edge, tension trailing edge tech. What that means is we basically have put a material in here, in this case, two layers of our triple rip, and it breaks up that seam so that when the kite starts to flap, we don't just have a straight edge back here that it can deter and start to break down on. So that different levels really make a difference, and that helps keep tension in the canopy, and that's really important. You can see down here in the wingtip, we have a really low application of Dacron. We found over the years, you actually don't really need that much Dacron for turning response. All it does is add weight. So we have a low application here to give us wingtip rigidity. You see it stops there, and that's just gonna save a lot of weight. Now, weight is a really important thing when it comes to a kite. It's got to fly in the sky, so you really want something that is as efficient and light as possible. And we achieve that, like I said, by, you know, changing our bridle structure, using different materials in the construction of the kite. But the biggest weight savings you can get is in the bladder. So we actually dropped 0.02 mm in our bladder thickness, and it has reduced the weight of a standard 12 meter by over a pound. So that's a pound taken out of something that needs to fly. That gives you better lightweight performance, light wind performance, and as well just makes the kite rise up out of the sky, makes it easier to relaunch, makes it easier to sneak on an airline. Like, it just adds in all of the best things that you can for the kite. We still hold true to our max flow inflation system here. We have our one pump inflation, which means you only need to pump from one spot. This year we did do some retooling on our one pump valve. I'm gonna pull it out here. You can see it's got a little rubber O-ring and gasket in here. That just means that the cap is now a complete airtight seal, not just a flap on the inside. So that's just gonna ensure that you never have an accidental deflation or anything weird, and it just keeps that air right where you want it inside the kite. As far as coming down here, you can see we have some patches on the canopy to protect against one pump abrasion. Out here, we have our new ballistic material. It's a lot lighter and more aerodynamic than the EVA padding that we had on here before. So once again, absolutely lighter than it was before and a little bit tougher and stronger. It's again our layered frame construction as we come down here. Now, one thing I do want to point out on this kite that people might not actually notice, and I say this about all our kites, is we've always had this ability to change the amount of bar pressure and turning response on the kite just simply by changing where this knot flies on the trailing edge. The kites are going to come stock in the middle setting, but as you can see, it's already moved up to the front setting. And the reason why that is I personally prefer more bar pressure when I fly the kite. So I went ahead and moved it up to the top knot, and I happily got an increase in bar pressure. It helped me feel where the kite is and really gave me that strong turning response. Now, Luke, our surf rider, he's actually quite the opposite. He likes lighter bar pressure, so he actually flies his all the way to the trailing edge. And so I just want you guys to know that there is some variance, and it does change, you know, 2 pounds, maybe 3 pounds of pressure on that bar pressure. And for some of you coming from other wave kites that are heavy on the bar, you know, you can find that happy home here on the Wow. So that's kind of the design characteristics in a nutshell. It's the Wow, it's boxier, it's got better arcing, or better turns, it's got more precision control, it's more rigid, it's got more raw power, and that sweet spot has really grown to where the kite lives in a lot more wind conditions and just happier overall. And I can't believe how good it's been working for me here in the Gorge. Yeah, I don't have waves, but I sure do like to boost, and I sure do like to slash river swell. And I gotta say, this thing's working amazing. So hats off to Julian and the whole design team at Liquid Force. Hope you enjoy it.